you step forth into the illusionary lands. The goddess's powers of resurrection cannot reach you here. Shaking thud that parts the clouds, the ancient dragon falls. You have returned it to its eternal sleep. The immortal dragon slumbers once again. Congratulations, hero. With your own hands, you have defeated a myth. The dragon's crown lay near the ancient dragon. It was the cause of this incident, but you can make it a symbol of hope. Without the demons, this is just an ordinary crown. However, the minds of the people have ascribed great power to it. You need to offer the dragon's crown to the new queen, Vivian. The crown of the Elysian king fits her well. With the legendary crown, the royal scepter, and orb, none can deny her rightful ascension to the throne. The dragon's crown will be a symbol of power, inspiring fear in the hearts of any who would threaten Heidland. It represents the fact that warriors who defeated the mightiest foes reside in Heidland and will rise to defend it from any threat. Queen Vivian invites you to work at the castle. You value your freedom, so you politely decline. However, you vow to work for the queen whenever the need may arise. In turn, she blesses you with the royal favor for life. As you exit through the Great Gate, many soldiers turn and salute. You have completed a legendary accomplishment. Queen Vivian would lead Heidland well, reclaiming its past borders and reasserting itself as a powerful nation. The tale of the Dragon's Crown ends here. Despite accomplishing enough for myriad lifetimes, your story is just beginning. You suddenly remember the moment you left the village. You had just been acknowledged as a mature warrior. Long ago, in the wildlands, a carriage was waylaid by orcs. Only an infant survived. You. You came to Heidland to discover your roots, but you had given up by the time the Dragon's Crown incident occurred. While the citizens grant you a hero's welcome, an elderly noble couple look at you in stunned surprise. They will soon realize that you have the same eyes as their son, who died years ago in a remote land.